For medical school, you apply to multiple schools, hopefully get several acceptances, and choose the program that you like most. For residency, it's not so straightforward. Instead, you'll be using the NRMP Match and its Nobel Prize-winning algorithm. Here's how it works. Dr. Jabal, MedSchoolInsiders.com. To properly understand how the match works, we first need to understand the issues that it addresses. Before the National Resident Matching Program, or NRMP, there was a straightforward traditional application system, just like you would use for applying to medical school. Back then, hospitals benefited from filling positions as early as possible, and applicants benefited from delaying acceptances. These factors led to offers being made for positions up to 2 years in advance before starting residency. In response, medical schools began to only release transcripts and letters of recommendation during the student's final year. Competition then took another form, whereby programs issued exploding offers, requiring the medical students to accept or reject a residency offer within 24 to 48 hours. There were other problems too. Competitive applicants would hold on to multiple program offers, or would renege on accepted offers when a better one came along. Programs were pressured to extend early offers to secure the best candidates. In short, it was a mess. Enter the NRMP Match, the aim of which was to promote an even playing field. It's based on an algorithm first described in the 1960s, for which Lloyd Shapley and Alvin Roth were awarded the Nobel Prize in Economics in 2012. Each September, fourth-year medical students apply to residency using ERAS, the Electronic Residency Application Service. From October to January, they'll be offered interviews at various residency programs. In February, both the residency programs and the applicants will submit their rank order list. A rank list is an ordered list in decreasing preference of the programs an applicant would like to attend, or a list of the applicants a program would like to recruit. Let's take a look at how this works in real life. Say we have 5 applicants and 3 residency programs, and each of them submit their own rank lists. The algorithm is applicant proposing, meaning it prioritizes what the applicants submit rather than the programs. First, the algorithm will start with John, who ranked City first. City ranked him as well, at number 2. He's now tentatively matched at City. We say tentative because if there is another applicant who is higher ranked at the program, the algorithm may bump the lower ranked candidate depending on the number of seats available. Next, we'll go to Charlene, who also ranked City first. City ranked her third, so she'll tentatively match there for now. Zach ranked City first, and City ranked him at number 5. Since the 2 seats are already tentatively assigned to other applicants, the algorithm cannot assign Zach to City. Instead, it moves to his number 2 position, County. County ranked him, so he's tentatively matched there for now. Linda ranked Private first, but Private didn't rank her, so the algorithm will go to her number 2. She ranked City next, but she's at number 4, and the 2 seats are already claimed by applicants higher on City's list. The algorithm moves to her third choice, County, and tentatively matches her there for now. Mark ranks City first, and City ranked him first as well. A match made in heaven. This is a confirmed match, not a tentative match, as there's no possibility for another applicant to be ranked higher at City. But in doing so, Charlene got bumped off. The algorithm will try to match her to a second program, but Private didn't rank her. She ends up going unmatched. In the end, this is what the final match results look like. John and Mark both ended up at their number 1 ranked programs, so big congratulations to them. Zach and Linda didn't match at their number 1 picks, but they still matched, and that's reason for celebration as well. Unfortunately, Charlene and Private both ended up going unmatched. You'll note that both had shorter rank lists. This isn't a coincidence. Generally speaking, you're less likely to successfully match with a shorter rank list for 2 reasons. First, statistically, there are fewer opportunities for a match to occur with a shorter list. Second, more competitive and desirable applicants are usually offered more interviews. Not only are they generally ranked higher on the program's list, but because they attended more interviews, they have longer lists as well. Rank lists are submitted by both applicants and programs at the end of February, and match day occurs in the second half of March. It's a formal celebration at all medical schools across the country. Students open an envelope, inside which is the residency program they will be training at for the next 3 to 7 years. If you go unmatched, all hope is not lost. During match week, you'll be part of a process called SOAP, standing for Supplemental Offer and Acceptance Program. During this time, unmatched applicants and unfilled residency programs will connect. Oftentimes, these unmatched applicants will take on preliminary or transitional year residency programs, which last only 1 year, meaning they will apply again to residency during the next application cycle. Now that you understand the basics of the match and how the algorithm works, let's debunk some of the common myths that lead applicants astray. First, always rank every program you interviewed at. Since matching at a program is a binding commitment, it's important to rank only programs where you would be happy to train. When I was applying to plastic surgery residency, there were a couple programs I didn't rank because I knew I wouldn't be happy there. It's ultimately a personal decision, and for me, I would have rather gone unmatched than train at those programs. It's also important to note that programs will only rank applicants they have interviewed, so there's no benefit to listing programs at which you weren't offered interviews. Number 2, the algorithm favors residency programs over applicants. Prior to 1995, the NRMP matching algorithm favored residency programs over applicants, such that it proposed matches based on the program's rank order list rather than the applicants. In a very small number of cases, applicants ended up at lower ranked programs compared to if the algorithm was applicant proposing. So since then, the algorithm became applicant proposing, which is good for medical students. It's been this way for over 2 decades, and it's time to quit with the conspiracy theories. Number 3, changing rank lists last minute. Don't wait until the last minute to make any changes to your rank list. Similarly, don't wait until the last minute to finalize your rank list. It's important to weigh multiple factors to make the rank list that's gonna make you the happiest come match day. If any part of the process is rushed, a rash decision has a high probability of leading to regret. And number 4, rank programs based on them ranking you. The most pervasive myth is that the order of your rank list should be dependent on where you think you have been ranked highly, rather than your true order of preference. By understanding how the algorithm works, it becomes clear that you should rank programs in your order of preference, meaning if you want to go to prestigious program X, rank them as number 1, even if you think they didn't rank you as highly. Trying to outsmart the system by ranking a program higher because you think they also ranked you higher doesn't actually improve your match outcomes. It's actually just more likely to result in you going to a program you're not as happy with. The only time this sort of game theory actually comes into play is under 2 specific conditions, both of which must be met. First, you're applying to smaller specialties, like plastic surgery, ENT, interventional radiology, and several others, where the faculty and programs are well connected. And second, you or your advocate informs your number 1 ranked program that you've ranked them as such. There are several rules and restrictions around this, so only proceed with professional guidance. Programs like matching with students who have ranked them highly, and this sometimes can sway a program's rank list by a couple spots. It will not move an applicant from the bottom of the list to the top, but it can move you from number 3 to number 2, and that can be the difference between you matching there and not. This is a much more advanced and high-risk topic that is dependent on multiple specific factors to each student, and for that reason, it's not something I'll be discussing further on video. Rather, this sort of advanced theory and application of rankless strategies is best suited for one-on-one guidance from a physician with real experience on residency admissions committees. And that's where our team of top-tier physicians at Med School Insiders comes in. We've served on residency admissions committees, worked with hundreds of faculty members and program directors, relentlessly studied the literature on the match and optimizing outcomes, and have honed the systems to help you succeed. We'll help you optimize your whole application process, from the personal statement, ERAS, helping you master your interview skills, and even optimizing your rank list so you're ecstatic on match day. Learn more at medschoolinsiders.com. I'm hoping this clarifies much of the confusion about the match and rank list. For anyone who is applying to residency soon, I wish you the best of luck. If you enjoyed this video, leave us a thumbs up to keep the YouTube gods happy, and subscribe with the notification bell enabled if you want to see more content like this. Much love to you all, and I will see you guys in that next one.